Want to meet 5 amazing words and remember them for a lifetime? Well, you have reached the best destination on the internet to do so. This is Amit Kumar Mehta, and today I'll be helping you master those 5 difficult words in a very, very simple way so that you can remember them for your lifetime. Now, before I start, let me tell you, words number 1, 2, 3 and 5 are my favorites for the day. I'm Amit Kumar Mehta, and I've been helping students, working executives, housewives master those difficult words since the last 5 years in a very, very simple way. These are words which are favorite of editorial columns. These are words which are favorite for any competitive exams which require English as a major component. Quickly moving on to the words for the day, let us start with my favorite word, word number 1, that is teetotalism. Teetotalism basically means complete personal restraint from alcohol. Somebody who does not drink alcohol at all. Who will go to a party but he will not drink alcohol, who is a teetotaler. Now Hindi would be mad sharab tyagna. Sharab tyagne wala insan is a teetotaler. Teetotalism. Antonym is overindulgence. Somebody who drinks a lot is an overindulgent. He is the opposite of teetotaler. Now what is the pronunciation? Teetotalism. Teetotalism, as the word is, that is how it is pronounced. Now what is the brain friendly way of remembering this particular word? Imagine somebody who is totally into tea, who does not drink anything but tea. So if somebody is totally drinking tea, 100% drinking tea, definitely he will not be having alcohol, and that is how you remember this particular word. What are the various usages? Completely teetotal. Teetotal Hindu pilgrims. Hindu pilgrims are generally teetotalers. Sentence 1. After the ban on liquor sale within 500 meters, bars, restaurants and casinos have now gone teetotal. Bars, restaurants and casinos have now gone teetotal, seriously threatening Goa's image as a party destination. Goa is known for a party destination, but because of the government regulations, most of the bars, casinos have become teetotal. Sentence 2. TV star Lisa Ray revealed this week going teetotal helped her lost an unbelievable 20 pounds. If somebody is gaining weight and wants to lose weight, somebody who is a drinker, leave alcohol and you will suddenly find your weight suddenly drops. And that is what Lisa Ray is saying. When she went teetotal, her weight reduced dramatically. Moving on to the next word for the day, which I told you is again my favorite, temerity. Temerity is basically audacity. Audacity, boldness, brazenness, rashness, daring. Hindi would be dussahas. Aapke andar sahas hai, aapke andar gustaki karne ki chahat hai, that is dussahas hai, that is basically temerity. Temerity is the opposite would be shyness or bashfulness. Somebody who is shy is the opposite of temerity. Temerity is somebody who has got the audacity, who has got the boldness to fight any situation. Pronunciation is temerity. Temerity. Now what is the brain friendly way which we are looking for? What is the brain friendly way of remembering this particular word for a very, very long time? Look at the visual, look at the underlined portion, the merit. That is how it can be looked at as. Now the merit, if somebody has got merit, if the person has got merit, definitely he will be confident about his merit, he will be bold about his statements, he will be audacious in whatever decisions or statements he speaks. So anybody with merit is audacious, is bold, has temerity. Anybody who has merit has temerity, is bold, is audacious. Now what are the various usages? Temerity to go against the BJP, temerity to go against the system, the law, the police, temerity to question, somebody having the temerity to question in the classroom, somebody having the temerity to question the leader. Sentence 1. The Prime Minister had the temerity to take such a hard decision to fight black money and corruption, Arun Jaitley said. Not everybody could have taken the step of demonetization. PM Modi had the temerity, he had the audaciousness, he had the boldness to do that particular thing. Sentence 2. Upendranath Brahmachari had the temerity to apply for India's national coach. Though he was not capable, though he did not have the ability, though he did not have the experience, he had the temerity, he had the boldness to apply for that particular position. Not only is he unknown, he totally lacks experience in cricket. Sentence 3 and 4 you can do on your own. Now the link to all these 1200 words are available in the YouTube description. Go to the YouTube description and download all the words through this particular which we teach in the best possible way, in the easiest possible way on the internet. Go and download all those words. It will actually help you sound sophisticated and score more in examinations. Moving on to the third word for the day, which again is my favorite, tenacious. Tenacious basically means somebody who is persistent, somebody who is determined, somebody who is single-minded with a strong focus, his strong will to do something. Hindi would be hathi, jo hath karta hai ki maine zid kar li hai ki main karunga hi karunga. Hindi also Hindi is sakt, he's very strict, he's very determined, he's very persistent. Antonym is somebody who is weak, somebody who is irresolute. Matlab who can change his plans on a daily basis is somebody who is weak or irresolute. He does not have a resolution, who does not follow resolution, is the opposite of tenacious. Now pronunciation is tenacious, tenacious, tenacious. Now what is the brain friendly way? What is the brain friendly way of remembering this particular word for a very very long time? Suppose there is a particular person who never does a particular thing with one level of percentage. He does it with 10 times the effort. He puts 10 times the effort into any act that he does. Imagine 10 ACs working at the same time. That is how he works. If he will work, he will work 10 times. 10 ACs he will put to work to get a particular job done. And that is what is meant by persistent. He's absolutely persistent. He's totally given into the particular job. He will do it with his 100%, 10 times conviction. And that is tenacious for you. Somebody who's tenacious is persistent. Now, what are the various usages? The tenacious women cricket team. The women cricket team is tenacious. They are giving a lot of effort. They are determined. They are persistent. They'll keep on working. They'll keep on practicing. Tenacious efforts. Sentence 1, Wadilal ice creams have been the tenacious tortoise which has seen several rabbits fall by the wayside. Wadilal ice creams have been tenacious throughout the years. They have been persistent. They have been working very, very hard. I'm really sorry for the disturbance that might be coming. There's a drilling work going on, but I'm really sorry. But let us continue with the word. Sentence 2, after Kohli's dismissal, the tenacious 20-year-old batted responsibly to score his second ODI century and ensured India's wins. After Kohli's dismissal, the team was probably, you know, going shaky, and at that point of time, the tenacious 20-year-old particular person was very persistent. 20-year-old was very persistent, very determined to take India to the victory, and that is why he kept on working and got India to victory. That is what is meant by tenacious. Moving on to the next word for the day is a tete-a-tete. Tete-a-tete is a cozy chat, a heart-to-heart talk. One-to-one chat is kind of a chit-chat. Imagine coffee with Karan. It's a tete-a-tete, which is basically when you're talking to a particular person one-to-one. Hindi, tete-a-tete over a cup of tea, casual tete-a-tete, quick tete-a-tete. Sentence, in tete-a-tete with business times, the actor opens about why he thinks the right kind of attitude matters a lot in the entertainment industry. In a tete-a-tete, in a small talk. Sentence 2, officials and ministers will be hoping that the opportunity for India-Pak tete-a-tete will unlock the ties. The tete-a-tete between India and Pakistan can probably solve the crisis. But there needs to be a talk. That is a tete-a-tete. Sounds like talk, and that is how you remember this particular word. Now, moving on to the last word for the day, the fifth word, and again, my favorite word for the day is thwart. Thwart. Now, what is the meaning? It means preventing something, stopping something, opposing something, foiling, impeding, countering something. Hindi would be vifal karna. Thwarting is basically putting brakes to somebody's ideas, putting brakes to somebody's concepts is thwarting. You are stopping it from getting done. That is thwarting. Antonym would be encourage. आप stop कर रहे हैं तो आप रोक रहे हैं, आप encourage कर रहे हैं तो उल्टा काम कर रहे हैं. Thwart का उल्टा हो गया encourage and assist. Pronunciation is thwart. Thwart. Now what is the brain friendly way? What is the wordaholic's way? How can you remember this word using visuals, using underlining method and the mnemonics? Look at the visual that we have provided. This girl is having a wart. She's having a pimple on her face. And this pimple is preventing her from getting the beauty pageant, from becoming Miss Universe, Miss World, or maybe going to a party. So this pimple, this wart on her face, the small wart, the small pimple, is stopping her from going to a particular party. It's thwarting. That wart is stopping her, is thwarting her from going to a particular party, from winning Miss Universe, from winning Miss World. Now that is how you remember this particular word. Moving on to the usage, India thwart Pakistan. India have stopped Pakistan. Thwart the Aussie attack. The bowlers, Indian bowlers, thwart. They stopped the Aussie attack. Sentence 1, Singur would thwart the possibility of any entrepreneur showing interest in making fresh investments in Bengal. The Singur episode where Tata was asked to move out of Singur to build a plant it has, you know, killed any possibility, it has thwarted any possibility, it has stopped the entire possibility of some entrepreneur coming to Bengal to invest. Sentence 2, Noor, who had helped thwart a terror attack on Indian consulate this year, is a strong advocate of Afghan-India ties. Noor, who had thwarted the terror attack, somebody who had stopped the terror attack, somebody who had foiled or impeded the entire terror attack, somebody who had thwarted it. Now that is how you remember this particular word. Sentence 3, 4, you can do on your own by pausing the video. With that particular word, we have reached the end of the presentation for today, and I hope you have liked the presentation. And as I keep on saying, keep sounding sophisticated, keep scoring more. And if you have not liked our page, if you have not subscribed our page, please do subscribe, please do like, and please share it with somebody whom you think these words can matter. For a matter of fact, a playlist section on our YouTube channel today contains more than 300 such words discussed in an amazingly simple way, so that anybody, even a 6th grader, that is our challenge, even a 6th grader can understand what we are saying and how we are saying, and probably remember these words. And these words can help those students sound sophisticated in social settings, score more in front of any particular examinations, and cast a very good impression and kill all the fear of English. I hope you're liking the video. I hope you are enjoying it. Keep sharing and keep subscribing. Thanks for the love. Thank you so much.